refractive index. Refractive index is actually a measure of optical density of the medium. Otherwise, we can say it gives an idea about the speed of light in that medium. So now we are considering two medium. This is medium 1 and this is medium 2. Light passes from first medium to second medium. Okay. Now let us assume that this medium 1 is less optical denser and medium 2 is high optical denser. Okay. Or the optical density is lesser for first medium and it is greater for the second medium. And we know velocity of light will be more if the optical density is less. So here the velocity of light will be high, and when the optical density is high, velocity of light will be lesser. Now I told you this refractive index is a measure of optical density, isn't it? So the medium which is having less optical density will be having high refractive index. A medium with less optical density will be having less refractive index. So here N1, that is the refractive index of the first medium. First medium is having less optical density, so refractive index will be lesser. Now the second medium is having high optical density, so the refractive index of that medium will be greater. Now from this we can understand the medium which is having less refractive index will be having higher velocity, and the medium which is having low refractive index will be having high velocity. Okay, so the medium which is having higher refractive index will be having lower velocity. So velocity and refractive index are having a reciprocal relations with each other. Now always when we say about the refractive index, not only about one medium, we have to compare the two media where the light passes from one medium to another medium, only refraction happens, isn't it? So when we say about the refractive index, that is actually a measure of deviation from one medium to another medium. So when we say about the refractive index, we have to compare both the media. So in this case, light passes from first medium to second medium. So we say the refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. Always the light passing from one medium to the other medium. So the initial direction is taken as the first medium and the final direction is taken as the second medium. So refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium, N21 is equal to N2 by N1, where N2 is the refractive index of second medium with respect to air and N1 is the refractive index of first medium with respect to air. Okay, so when we compare the refractive index of one medium with respect to air, that is known as absolute refractive index. Absolute refractive index. So absolute refractive index is the refractive index of one medium by comparing to air. So absolute refractive index of any medium N equal to C by V, where C is the velocity of light in that light in air and V is the velocity of light in that medium. So for first medium, N1 is equal to C by V1, where V1 is the velocity in the first medium, and N2 is equal to C by V2, where V2 is the velocity of light in the second medium. So substituting that here, N21 is equal to N2 by N1, that is equal to C by V2 divided by C by V1. C and C will cancel, V1 by V2. So N2 by N1 is equal to V1 by V2. From this we can understand the velocity and refractive index are having a reciprocal relationship. When refractive index is higher, velocity of the light will be lesser. Now, also, suppose in the reverse case, light passes from this medium to this medium. Okay, the direction of arrow is just opposite. So, in that case, this is the second medium and this is the first medium. So, we have to write N12. Refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium. So n1 2 that is equal to n1 by n2. So comparing this two, n21 is n2 by n1, n12 is n1 by n2. One is the just reciprocal of the other one. So n21 is equal to 1 by n12. Okay. And also we have to understand one more thing here. If we have the refractive index of different media, we will get the refractive index of one media from that. That is n 3 1 we need, suppose that is equal to n3 by n1. Okay, so we can multiply and divide with n2, so that won't change the value in the equation. So n3 by n2 that is equal to n32 into n2 by n1 that is n21. So if we have n32 that is the refractive index of third medium with respect to second medium and refractive index of second medium with respect to the first medium, then by doing like this we will get the refractive index of third medium with respect to the first medium. Like that by using the equations also we can find the refractive index with respect to any two media if we have the other knowledge about the refractive index of different combinations of media.